Hello, and how are you all today? My name is Priyanka and I shall be helping you with the following question. And the question says, find the mean and standard deviation using shortcut method. Now, before proceeding on, we should be well versed with the shortcut method for finding mean and standard deviation. First of all, their formulas will be equal is x bar is equal to A, where A is the assumed mean, plus H multiplied by, in the numerator, summation Fi by I, where I is equal to 1 to N, and in the denominator we have summation Fi, where I is equal to 1 till N. Now here, what is A, H and Y will be more clearer to you once this method will be used by me in this question. Now, let me write down the formula for variance also. That is, now here we do not need to find the variance, but for finding out the standard deviation also, we need to firstly find out the variance and then we can only find out the standard deviation. So, the formula is h square upon summation fi, I is equal to 1 till n, the whole square, into summation fi into summation fi yi the whole square, I is equal to 1 till n, minus summation fi yi the whole square. So this formula looks a little bit confusing, but as we will be solving it with the help of our table method and the shortcut method, it will be easier for you to understand it. And lastly, we will obtain standard deviation that is equal to square root of variance. Right, so these three formulas will be helping us in the following question, and hence they are the key ideas towards this question. So let us firstly make a table in which we will write down the xi and fi's which are given to us. Now here we have xi and fi. Now in this shortcut method, we will assume any observation from xi as the assumed mean. Let us take 64 as our assumed mean. Let us denote it by A. Right? And h is the difference between any two consecutive xi, and that, if you observe, in each of the case is equal to 1. Right? So what we have done over here is we have assumed mean, that is A equal to 64, and h is the difference between any two consecutive xi's, and that is, if you subtract any one, that is 66 minus 65, let's say, it is coming out to be 1. So here we have A is equal to 64 and H is equal to 1. Now, we will find out YI. And YI is XI minus the assumed mean. So it is 60 minus 64 giving us minus 4. Then 61 minus 64 minus 3. Then we have minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and then we have 4. That is 68 minus 64. Now, I need to multiply Fi with Yi. And that is 2 into minus 4, minus 8, 1 into minus 3, minus 3, 12 into minus 2, minus 24, and so on. We have the following Xi, Fi's. Now, with the help of shortcut method, you are actually simplifying your calculations. Further, we need to find out Yi the whole square also. So, it will be the square of all Yi, that is 16, then 9, 4, 1, 0, 1, 4, 9, and then again 16. Then multiply Yi with Fi with Yi whole square also. And on doing so, we have 2 into 16 giving us 32. 1 into 9 giving us 9. Then we have 12 into 4. 48 and so on, 29, 0, 12, 40, 36 and 80. Now, we need to find out the sum of Fi, Yi the whole square, that is 286. Then the sum of Yi square, that is 60. The sum of Yi, Fi will be 0. And lastly, the sum of Fi, which is 100. Now, we will be finding out, first of all, mean. Let us write down the formula, that is A plus H into summation Fi, Yi, I is equal to 1 till n. Divided by summation Fi, I is equal to 1 till n. Now here, A is 64, H is 1, it will get multiplied by the summation of Fi, Yi was found to be above as 0. So it will be 0 divided by 100. So this whole term will become equal to 0. So we have the mean as 64. Now proceed on to find out the variance. Now this is the formula which is known to us. Now on substituting the value, we have H as 1, summation of Fi as 100. So it will be 100 the whole square into summation of Fi is 100 will get multiplied by summation Fi Yi the whole square, square, and it is found out above as 286, isn't it? Minus summation Fi Yi was 0, so its whole square will again give us 0. Simplify it, we have 1 upon 10,000 into 28600. Now, simplifying it, we have the answer as 2.86, right? And don't forget, you need to find out the standard deviation. So, standard deviation is under root the variance. Variance is 2.86. So, its square root is 1.69. So, we can write the answer to the session as mean was found out to be 64 and standard deviation is 1.69. Right. This completes my session. Hope you understood the whole concept well and also the formulas that were explained to you in the starting of the session. Have a very nice day ahead. Take care of your calculations.